Welcome students to Rayobyte University's introductory video lecture on the subject of web scraping. I'm Dean Coleman, and I understand webs are the things spiders make, and scraping is what happens when I drive too close to certain professors' cars in the parking lot. But how do they go together? For the answer to this and many more questions, we'll be turning to the man with the ruined Toyota Corolla next to the handicap space, Professor of Innovation, Neil Amy.
That was you?
Irrelevant! Please, tell us what web scraping is and what it has to do with us.
Well, so web scraping is defined by the automated process of gathering data from a target website. So it's a verb. You go out and scrape something, and it's you using your software, going to a site, getting that data, and bringing that in. There's so many use cases far and wide that are common in the world today, and we as consumers are using scraped data every single day that we're online.
Since our students can't physically interact with you, I'll help them out by asking the question every professor just loves to hear. When will we use this in the real world?
So, as I said, the use cases are far and wide. Think about the last time you bought a flight online. Maybe you go to Google Flights, maybe you go to Skyscanner, for example. And when you make your search, what do you see? You see a list of a bunch of different airlines and the prices. And typically, as consumers, we're looking for the cheapest price, right? Well, how do you think these websites are getting that data from all these many different airline sites? Airlines aren't giving that data out for free, because if they're giving it out for free, their competitors would get it, right? And so these sites and these whole industries have been built by scraping data and bringing into one cohesive user experience for us, the consumers, to get value out of.
Now, Neil, like all men of a certain age, I get all my news from half-remembered articles on social media. And I seem to recall that scraping can sometimes be used for nefarious purposes, like collecting my carefully hidden post-it note passwords, or even conducting robot invasions of the internet. Are you teaching our students how to do such crimes?
Example is when you're buying a flight online. When you go to like Google Flights or Skyscanner or so on and so forth, when you search your flight or your destination, what do you see? You see a list of airlines and their prices. Typically, as consumers, we want the cheapest price possible, right? Well, Google Flights, Skyscanner, they bring that in and they show it to us, because those target websites, the flight companies, the airlines in this case, aren't giving that data out for free, because then their competitors would just take that and obviously use that against them. And so this whole industry of web scraping has been built up to automate the collection of data. Let me give you another example, e-commerce. E-commerce is huge, right? Well, how do you think the Walmarts and the Amazons and the Targets of the world, how do they know what the cheapest price is of the product, so that they can sell it cheaper on their site? Well, they're web scraping, of course, right? And so what we offer here with Rayobyte University is the chance to be a part of this. You can learn the skills to be a web scraper and be a part of this data collection process across all these many industries out there.
Well, against all odds, the professor's wise words and the pathetic tone of voice in which he delivered them have convinced me of the importance of web scraping. But how do we actually do it? Let's all tune in next time to find out.